The L van subway, I was trying to think of the right word for it. It adds a percussion to the area with the noise that comes by. The old line is people get used to it. I don't think people really do get used to it, but it's background. It blends in. It's like the beat. It's like the heartbeat. In this line in particular, everybody who's ridden it at one point or another has a great story to tell about it. It's not so much with other lines, but there's something about this line and the communities that it serves, and it's like you can't have one without the other.
El tren 7, pues ayuda a la comunidad, a todas las personas. Es una forma positiva que a veces la gente pasa, mira los letreros del negocio y eso ayuda para la publicidad. La Roosevelt acapara mucho personas latinas. Mucha gente han venido y han puesto sus negocios, así como nosotros también estamos aquí poniendo un granito de arena.
Inherently, people have been building and been centralizing right on Roosevelt Avenue. It may be not a coincidence because of the proximity of the 7 train and them wanting that being prime real estate, you know?
Tren 7, que para la comunidad hispana se puede decir que es un primordial, es el número uno en transporte público, porque sin el Tren 7 yo creo que sería muy difícil de que la gente que todo vive lo que es Corona, Woodside, Jackson Heights e inclusive Flushing, pues no tuviéramos transporte público sin el 7, ¿no?
Maybe the faces have changed, but in certain ways, but it's always been that same environment. That it's like the area you grew up around the subway.
It's interesting because riding the 7 line, wow, for almost 30 plus years, the change has not been something that I can say I've noticed, because it's always been this way. It's always been the different cultures. It's always been getting on the train and seeing the cultures of Mexico, Ecuador, India, Ireland. It's been consistent in that way. Even though neighborhoods change, the cultures really haven't. They've kind of moved around a bit, but it's been the same way consistently for 30 years, which is interesting, because we always talk about how New York City as a whole changes, how Queens changes, and the idea of gentrification, but the 7 line has been consistently that cultural, that melting pot, you know?